Hey YouTube, iPodX102 here. In this segment, we're going over all of the new features in iOS 7.1, which was just released to the public today. I'll start off by saying that if you're jailbroken or are planning to jailbreak in the future, do not update to this, as it is completely patched the evasion jailbreak exploits, so you cannot jailbreak this software version. So if you do want to jailbreak, do not update to stay on something 7.0 point something, and you can still jailbreak using the evasion tool. If you just search my channel, you'll find a tutorial for that. But this video is just going to go over all the new features, so let's get started. Let's start off with a feature for Siri. You can now have it stop listening to when you're speaking by simply letting go of the home button. If you continue to hold the home button the entire time you're speaking and then let go, it will then stop listening when you let go of the home button. So this is going to be useful for if you have lots of crowds around you, and it's let's say you're in a party or something and there's music playing, that it would detect the music as speech and wouldn't stop listening, and you'd have to just tap the home button or Siri button on the screen to stop it listening. But this is quite cool because you can just let go of the home button to do it. So if I show you here, this is a test. And as soon as I let go of the home button, it stops listening. So that's quite cool. There is actually a period of time where it has to be held down for a certain period of time for it to detect that you're holding it down while you're speaking. Otherwise, it won't stop listening until you stop speaking, and it's detected that, which is kind of a downside. But that's just to stop it from stop listening from when you accident. Like, so let's say you just brought it up and you stopped and you wanted to speak to it. Just to fix that bug where it would stop just as you're about to say it, I guess. We've also got some new icons for the phone, messages, and FaceTime app. There's only slight differences, but as you can see, the colours are just less vibrant. They're just slightly darker, which does look a bit better and blends in with the iOS 7 theme a bit more. The phone app now also has a new dialer, so as you can see, you have the same number icons, but you have a new call button. So instead of having this, which is on iOS 7.0, you now have this little round icon with a phone icon in it. Which is quite cool, rather than just seeing a box with call in it. I think it does look a lot better. There's a new slide to power off UI, and it also does apply to the slide to answer for the phone app. But as you can see, if I hold down the home button here, I'll get a brand new UI. It just sort of appears, slides from the left to the right, which looks quite cool. You've got the round cancel button, you've got the round power button with a red power icon in it, and you've also got the slide to power off text. And also what's quite cool is as you slide this, the screen brightness goes down, so it'll actually look a lot better when you're turning it off rather than just going to black straight away, which I think is quite cool. I'm obviously not going to do this because then I'll have to reboot it, but you get the idea, and it is quite a cool feature. There's also a new slide to unlock animation. As you can see, it does look slightly different to the old one, where it's just not a slightly better color, just does look a whole lot better in my opinion. Now when opening Control Center, there is also a new bounce where you can see it bounces a lot more than it does in iOS 7.0. This is a feature that I don't think many people have noticed, but it is there. It does bounce a whole lot more. You can now go into Settings, General, and go down to Accessibility, wherever it is, there it is. Go down until you see the button shapes thing. So as you can see, button shapes, if you turn that on, now buttons will now have a shape around them, so they're easier to see where they are rather than just being a little arrow. So as you can see, this has now got a sort of arrow around it, and all of these buttons will now have that. Just basically anything that has a button. It's mainly these navigation buttons, but it does also apply to some other things as well. In Notification Center now, the no missed notifications in the All tab has been replaced with just no notifications, and now in the Missed tab, it now says no missed notifications. There's also a thing in iOS 7.0 where sometimes it didn't show up. I'm not really sure if that's just me or if it's happening for other people, but I found out that on iOS 7.0 I just noticed that these texts don't actually show up for me in Notification Center, so that might be a bug they fixed as well. And apart from that, that's all I can show you, but I can go over some other things as well. In the iPhone 5S, which is, this is an iPhone 5, so I can't really show you this, but in the iPhone 5S you now have HDR Auto, which basically enables the HDR mode automatically when your device detects that it's needed. So if the colours aren't very bright, it'll turn that on. So that's quite a cool feature. You also have improved Touch ID, so it's a much more reliable and much more accurate when sensing your fingerprint. You also have improved performance on the iPhone 4, so the animations are going to be a lot, you know, smoother, and there's going to be less lag in apps and things. They now have fixed the home screen crash bug, so if some of you noticed that sometimes when you're using device, the device would just crash, it would show Apple logo and respring. That's apparently been fixed now, but I haven't really tested it out. So if it does happen to you, don't blame me, it's Apple, but hopefully they have fixed that for now. It also has added the new CarPlay support, which basically just enables some cars, which will be released soon, to integrate with the iPhone, so you can use all of your iPhone features in the car, which is quite cool, such things such as sat nav and maps and things like that. You also have iCloud keychains been enabled in more countries, and now you will have natural male and female voices added to Siri in multiple more languages. You have English UK, English Australian, Japanese and Chinese. It's been added to all of those, which previously didn't have it. And other than that, I think that's about it. There's like a few other things which aren't really that noticeable and don't even need to go over, but you'll notice those as you start using this. But other than that, I think it's a pretty small update. It's got a few nice features in it, but if it's, you were going to choose over this and your jailbreak, I'd definitely stay with jailbreak. Definitely don't upgrade if you want a jailbreak, because there won't be another untethered jailbreak coming out for any device anytime soon. So that's it. I hope you liked it. If there's anything I missed, make sure to comment them in the description below. And yep, I'll see you next video. Peace.